Welcome back to CN2 News. Only one time a year can I pull out the sash, and you can be sure I will every year. We want to welcome some friends from Keystone Substance Abuse Services to our studio. The Chocolate Festival now, I think, goes hand in hand with Keystone, which is a good thing. We'll explain why. Janet Martini, the Executive Director, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
And Daisy Burrows, the familiar face. We're going to explain why Daisy's here in just a minute. But Janet, first, let's talk about the Chocolate Festival, how long it's been going on, and really why you bring it back year after year.
Absolutely. This is our ninth annual chocolate extravaganza. And so we began this in an effort to thank the community and also invite community members to come and participate in a way that they can help us support folks that need our services, because we know that there are a lot of folks out in our community that either come to us in need, they come to us probably at a lower place in their life than they would like to be, whether they're uninsured or completely have no ability to pay. And so the things that we do every year is have fundraising events to help us continue to spread the word and continue to provide services for those folks that need our help.
And the event has transitioned a little bit over the years, but clearly a successful fundraiser. So share with folks a little bit about 1 week from today. So next Thursday, that's when the good's going on. So give people a little bit of an overview, if you would.
Yes. Next Thursday, we have our event is at Events at Manchester. It is from 6 to 8 p.m. And tickets are still available. They are $40 for an individual, and a couple can go for $75, and any way you want to mix that up is fine. And at the event, we will have a yummy buffet dinner by Michael's Cafe. And I'd like to say our presenting sponsor is Hospitality Heating and Air as well, so they are presenting sponsor this year as well. We will have silent and live auction items as well. We've got some wonderful things. We have a mountain house, we have a Charleston house, we have some football paraphernalia,
fun.
National championship paraphernalia,
yes.
Things. We'll have our second year is our chocolate throwdown, so the pump house won last year, so they are the defending champions.
Gotcha.
So they'll be coming back.
Good stuff. Well, you can't have a festival without a queen.
That's right.
So I was the queen in 2013. We've had nine, you mentioned, or this year
this
is nine.
This is nine.
So our ninth queen is going to be Daisy Burrows. Dun,
yay!
Da, da. So Janet, if you don't mind,
yes,
handing over what is quite familiar to Daisy.
Thank you.
A gal who's familiar with pageants and sashes and crowns herself.
Slide this one now.
Yes, do it. So she has been throned.
Yay.
We hand it off. So, Daisy, what do you think about the festival? I know you're so involved in the community. So, why was this something for you to get involved with?
Well, I've had the opportunity to go to the festival for the last couple of years, the extravaganza for the
That's
last
right.
couple of
Wait
years. Yes. And it's really just the mission behind Keystone. Everybody knows somebody who may know another person who has needed the services of Keystone and what they stand for. So, it's just a way to give back.
So this dress has made its way through the rounds. It's dry cleaned every
day.
But you will get to enjoy it, and there's little princesses that are running around too. And it's really about getting the community excited about something sometimes families don't feel comfortable talking about.
That's right. We are continuing to educate our community and making sure that folks are comfortable asking for help, because this is a medical issue. And through all of the work with folks in our community and folks like you, last year we were able to impact 62,792 people, and that's through all of our events, our community education, our treatment programs, our prevention programs, and all that. And we know that we have to continue to do more.
Yep. And you work, Daisy, at the hospital, and all of it ties back. Everything in the community really does tie together.
It does, and it's just a growing need in our community, and it's a privilege, really, to have the opportunity to help highlight, and do all that we can for Keystone.
Well, good stuff. So chocolate is in the air. And Janet, talk about kind of the future of Keystone. You guys, a year ago, opened up a wonderful new facility, but what are needs moving forward? Where would some of this money potentially go?
Absolutely. The needs that we are identifying are our programs. We have a big need in our community. Men coming to our services many times don't have health insurance or coverage. We have women who are pregnant that are coming to us. We have kids, young people, young adults, especially with the opioid epidemic that's going on right now. We're working very hard as a community, even through our York County All on Board Coalition as well, to educate. It has to be a multi-pronged approach. And so a lot of the funds that from the proceeds of our event will go in to help folks that need the services that could not afford it
Well, terrific. Details on your screen. Again, this is an annual event. It's around for a reason. Who doesn't like chocolate?
That's right.
So you'll be out there to celebrate all things yummy.
Exactly.
Awesome. Well, thank you, ladies, for coming by, and we'll be back after this.